Search area. The mysterious parameters that have always been there, but few people used it, and it was mostly overlooked or misunderstood. With the latest Mocha release, it's time for a change. It became much easier to see how changing the search area affects your track, so let's take a look how you can get better tracking results by understanding how it really works. So what I have here are some sample clips that I shot to demonstrate you the basic concept. We have the same object, same scene that I've just merged with the split screen, and the only difference is the speed of how fast the object is moving. I made the speed difference very obvious, so you really could see how different the search area would be for both of them. On the very first frame of the clip, I draw two simple shapes that would look more or less the same. By default, the horizontal and vertical values for the search area are set to auto. But it's a bit hard to understand what these values really mean. That's why in Mocha 2023 release, we added an option to visualize it. Now you can go up into layer mat options, click and hold, and in the drop-down menu, choose selected search area. Click on that, then enable your mats, and boom, now you can see the same way how Mocha sees. What it shows us is an area of pixels where Mocha would look for our object of interest in the next frame. When it is set to auto, the size of the search area is defined by two things. One of them is the spline itself. If I adjust the spline, it also affects the search area. The other thing is the tracked motion. But currently my playhead is located on the first frame and we don't have any track data at all. That's why both of these areas look the same. Yet. Look what will happen if I track just one frame forward. Suddenly, the search area for these two objects began to look completely different. This is because the search area is also calculated based on the estimated motion. For example, the top object does not move too much. Since we tracked one frame, Mocha now expects this object to continue moving at the same speed, and there is no reason to look for it across the entire frame. The small area to look for is just enough. This makes tracking go much faster and more accurate, rather than if Mocha would try to analyze the whole area of the frame, which is especially critical nowadays when resolutions are just keep getting bigger and bigger. The bottom object, on the other hand, is moving quite rapidly, so it requires a larger search area in order not to lose the object. Meaning, for the next frame, Mocha expects to find the same texture pattern rather here or here. I would track a few more frames, so you can see that this behavior remains consistent. Mocha does a pretty good job of estimating the motion and adjusting the search area on the fly, however, not all objects move in such a linear and consistent way. So there are rare cases where you would want to adjust the search area size manually. This is a perfect example of a clip where an object changes speed very quickly. Let's try to track it and see what will happen. I draw a circle shape and try to track forwards. It starts fine, but then oops, Mocha just refuses to continue to track. Let's enable the search area visibility to see why is that. The ball was completely static for the first half of the clip, and Mocha does not expect any rapid motion to happen. Our search area is simply not big enough to follow that motion. And sure, you could use things as adjust track or manual track, but the simpler solution would be just to increase the search area. I turn off the auto checkbox and adjust the values until it's big enough to cover the area where the object is going to be the next frame. Something like this. Now the track goes just fine until the ball completely leaves the frame. Problem solved! On a less explicit examples, you may not get an error, but instead, your shape may just slip from an object. Like here. And that's not due to occlusions, as I already excluded that with the masks. Let's see if the same trick would help us here. So I enable the search area visibility, turn off the auto checkbox. This size is probably too huge to me, so I actually make it a bit smaller. This should be fine. And give it a second try. Now we can successfully continue to track without any of the slipping and apply our favorite effects afterwards without the pain of doing the manual adjustments. But now you might mistakenly think that having a larger search area is always the cure. Why not just have it big all the time? Well, in some cases, having a bigger search area would lead into bigger trouble. If you ever had situations where your spline suddenly jumps in completely wrong direction, stick with me to learn why this may happen. If you're working on a clip that has a bunch of repetitive objects, like people wearing the same uniform or any other repetitive pattern, it's actually better to have a relatively small search area. Here I have a clip of a bunch of grapes. Say I want to track this particular one in the middle. Let's first take a look at how the tracking would go with the default setting, when the search area is set to auto. The height and the width is being adjusted every frame based on the tracked motion, and everything sticks pretty fine. But if the search area would be too large, this is what can happen. Due to some light changes and the fact that the all grapes are looking the same, it's hard for Mocha to get which one is which. Our shape suddenly jumped from one grape to another. But if I make the search area smaller again, the tracking would go just fine, as it should. That's why it is set to auto by default to help keep the tracking accurate. This works for most of the shots, but as we have seen, sometimes it is necessary to adjust it manually to get good results. Having the option to visualize it makes it much easier to get the size right. And here you have it! We've demystified how the search area really works, and now you can apply this knowledge to overcome some various tracking challenges that may have previously confused you. My name is Elizabeth Postol for Boris Effects. See you next time!